Hi, and welcome back. Since you seem to be interested in cloud computing, which remotely sends data, you probably also want to perform calculations and other image manipulations. Luckily, the Earth Engine lets you do all of this easily. As always, the docs tab is your friend. When you know what calculations you want to perform, you can go to a tab and search for ee.image. And again, this shows you all possible functions you can execute with the image object, such as add, a logic and, calculating the cosine, multiplications, and the list goes on. Most of the times, using them is really simple and you can just type the name of your first image followed by the function, and you put the name of the second image between the brackets of that function. With combinations of these functions, you can do almost anything you like, but there is a prettier solution than writing function after function. I'll get back to that in a while, but first let me give you an example of this first method. I think calculating the NDVI is a great example for this. The NDVI, or Normalized Difference Vegetation Index, is an index that represents the amount of green in a certain place. Since chlorophyll absorbs a lot of visible red light, while reflecting most of the near-infrared light, it can be remotely sensed by looking at these bands. The normalized difference of two bands is calculated by subtracting the bands and dividing that with the sum of the two bands. It is the difference of the two, and then normalized by dividing it by the max value, the sum. So the normalized difference. When doing this, we need to subtract the red band from the near-infrared band and divide that by the sum of the two bands. The Earth Engine has a specialized function for taking the normalized difference, but I will calculate it the other way for this example. The first thing we need to do is selecting the images we want to use as a source and isolate the bands which we need. I will use images from Landsat 8. I already made a video on how to filter these datasets, so I won't explain this here. You can select specific bands from an image by using the select function. You pass in the bands you want to select and it will create a new image with the chosen bands. You can also choose multiple bands, but we won't need that in this example. So I create a new image for the red band and a new image for the near infrared band. And I store these in new variables. And then I can calculate the NDVI by first subtracting the red band from the near infrared band, and then dividing that by the sum of the two bands. The final image now represents the NDVI with values close to 1 for land with a lot of green vegetation, values close to 0 when there is less vegetation, and even close to -1 when water is present. We will save the parameters so we won't have to adjust this the next time. And when we compare this result to the satellite image, it seems indeed correct that a high NDVI value indicates green vegetation. A second way to calculate its map would be with the expression function. This is a more structured manner of writing things and works like this. The first argument is the expression you want to execute. We wanted to calculate NDVI, so we will subtract the red band from the near infrared band and divide it by the sum of these two bands again. You can use any variable name you want, since the second argument will be a dictionary of the variable names you used with the corresponding data. So we used N, I, R and R, E, D as variable names and made a dictionary with these two as keys. And when we run this, we get the same result. The method is equal to the previous one, but in my opinion it's a lot more structured and easier to read. A few remarks though, we use the expression function on our image, but when declaring the variables of the expression, we point to completely new objects. It looks like we didn't even use the initial image at all, and that's true. The dictionary we created is especially for when you use additional parameters. when you want to access bands from the image on which you use the function, you can access them with the b function. You can use this function in the expression itself, and between the brackets you put the number of the band you want to select. I have printed the available bands real quick, and for calculating NVI we want to use bands 4 and 5. So this is the 3rd and 4th band since they start counting at 0. And now we can remove the dictionary. You could have also specified the name of the band instead of the number, but then you would have to make sure that you don't comment out the band name with the backward slash. Within the expression, you can use every arithmetic operation, such as addition, multiplication, taking the remainder, exponentiation, and so on. And that's it. Those are the ways that you can perform calculation with images in the Earth Engine. If you have any questions about this or another topic, let me know, and I will see you in the next video.